her.
Let's get Peaches of St. Valery out of the way. All right, 51st Highlanders. The Scottish division left behind at Dunkirk to guard the retreat. At the point that, you know, they had run out of ammunition and food, they were still fighting. They fought hand-to-hand in St. Valery, making the Germans clear every single building before they could get to the beach. The actor, Hugh Grant, his grandfather was a major in the Seaforth Highlanders, part of the 51st. At the point of at the point that they were actually given permission to surrender, told to surrender, he turned to his men. Now, he was a major, and he was in command because of attrition, a nice way of saying everyone else was dead above him. And what happened was, he turned to his men and he said, the Seaforth Highlanders have never surrendered, and we're not going to surrender today. Anyone who wants to can go out in the morning with the wounded. But the rest of us are going to hold on, and we'll make a break for it tonight. Many were captured, many were killed, but they did not surrender. It speaks to the tenacity of the Scottish people. There were no monuments or anything to the 51st. When they came back, basically officers were put out of the army. Their careers got ended, the enlisted put out. And this was one of what considered to be an elite division, the Highland Division. One thing Hugh Grant did was he started a fund, raised money, and actually had a monument built to the 51st. So there is now a monument. But, okay, let's do this.
It was in 1940, the last days of spring. We were sent to the Maginot Line, a fortress in France, built to halt the advance of an army from a different time. But we were soon overrun, outfought and outgunned, pushed further back every day. But we never be elite. High command would just leave us. So we fought every step of the way. Till the 51st Highlanders found themselves on the banks of the Somme one more time. They still wore the scars of that war to end wars. The old soldier scars deep in their minds. But they didn't stay long. The panzers rolled on as the battle waged west toward the sea. Until on June the 10th, when sapped of all strength, St. Valery. And all I recall is the last boat leaving, my brother on board, waving and calling to me. And the jock stranded there with a hands in on the beaches of St. Valery. So I huddled all night in this hammered old house as the shells and the bullets rained down. Till just before dawn, our hopes were still strong, for we moved to the beach from the town. But the boat that was there on the day we arrived was the last one that we'd ever seen. And with no ammo or food, Valery. And all I recall is the last boat leaving, my brother on board, waving and calling to me. And the jock stranded there, their hand in the air, on the beaches of St. Calvary. When I returned at the end of the war from a stalag where I'd been confined, I read all the battles the Allies had fought, Stalingrad, Alamein, and the Rhine. And with pride in their hearts, people spoke of Dunkirk, where defeat had become victory. But nobody mentioned that Highland division. They never heard of St. Valery. No stories, no statues to those who were killed. No honors to those who had died. Just a deep sense of shame, as though we were to blame. Though I knew in my heart we would die. So I've moved to a country I've come to call home. Though my homeland lies far o'er the sea. And I'll never return while my memory still burns on the beaches of St. Valery. And all I recall is the last boat leaving, my brother on board, waving and calling to me. And the jock stranded there, with their hands in the air, on the beaches of St. Valery.